In this video, we're going to start a new series on dealing with CSV files and doing Django. It's not the sexiest topic in the world, but it's something I frequently have to do, and in talking to other people, they have to deal with as well, and I've gotten a few emails on how to deal with CSV files, specifically in Django. However, the first video we're going to start out is how to use the CSV reader and writer in Python, specifically the reader and the DictReader, the writer and the DictWriter. It's going to be super basic, and if you need more expanded information, I suggest you check out the docs, but this will get you 90% of what you need most of the time. So to start, if we look in our directory, you can see we have two files, data1.csv and data2.csv. The only difference between these two is data2.csv has a CSV delimiter of pipes instead of commas, so that we can show how that works. If we open up our data1 CSV, we can see we have first name, last name, and job. These people are their first names, last names, and their jobs. Note at the bottom, we have some jobs that have spaces. So we'll open up our readcsv.py, and we'll import CSV. Then we're ready to get started. We'll use the with context, and we'll do an open of data1.csv. So this uses the built-in Python open ability to open up files. We'll use the r for reading, and we're going to use the name of data file to assign it so that we can deal with the file. The great thing about using with in this context is that it'll automatically do a file.close on the open instead of you having to manually call it. Then we're just going to do a for row in data, and then we're going to print row, and then actually it should be data file because we're going to go through each row of the data file. So with that, it should print out every row in the file. So if we jump over to the right and we try to run this file, you can see it prints everything out. It prints out each and every row, but it doesn't actually pull out the comma delimited information, which is exactly what we want to happen. So to do that, we're going to go above our for loop, and we're going to do data equals csv.reader. We're going to pass it in the data file, and then we're going to rename this data file in our for loop to data and try to run it again. And you can see we have all of our data, except this time they're in lists. And if you'll notice at the bottom, the two jobs with spaces, it separated out properly. So the final way we're going to look at this is we will jump back into our data reader, and we'll set the delimiter to a pipe and change the file to data2.csv, run it again, and it turns out just the same. So with all of this, let's say we want to use the dict reader instead of just the plain reader. If we change the reader to dict reader with a capital D and a capital R, run it again, you see we get a set of dictionaries this time with the first row of the CSV file as the keys to our dictionaries. So now we can refer to each row using a dictionary key. So we could do row and then in brackets do last name, first name, or job to get the specific piece of information. So now that we know how to read the data from a CSV file, let's look at how to write the data to a CSV file. If we'll open up our writecsv.py, go ahead and load in some data. We have a list of tuples with our data, and we have a set of headers that we want to use. We'll do our with open, and we're going to set our file to writedata1.csv and use W for the write, and we'll use our data file again. Now we're going to create a writer, and we're going to use the CSV writer. We're going to pass it on our data file, just like we did with our reader. We want to go ahead and write a single row of our headers so that we have those displayed at the top. Then we just want to write all of the rows in our list of tuples that we have at the very top. So go ahead and run this. You can see it errors out because we never imported CSV. Once we import CSV and try to run it again, it works just fine. We have our languages, our ability levels, and our started dates. Now let's say we want to do this with a dictionary. If we'll convert our data to dictionaries, we're ready to use the DictWriter. Change this to writedata2.csv, convert it to DictWriter. We need to remove the line for headers and add in field names equals headers. And then this CSV writer actually has a special method of writer.writeheaders that will write our headers out for us, in this case, the field names. So we get the same instance that we do before. And we'll just keep the write rows of data because the dict writer will read in the keys and know how to fill it in. If we'll go ahead and run this, you can see it works just fine. We get the results we expect back, except we used a dictionary this time instead of using a set list of tuples. So that's it. That's all there really is to using the CSV reader and the CSV writer. It's very simple. Python keeps it super simple to deal with. So with that, join us on our next video where we look at uploading CSV files to your project.